Hi, I'm Tam Boon, and this is my wife, Siew Lan. We would like to share how God saved me from COVID-19. Most people who had COVID-19 recovered quite fast, but I had it very tough. I hold the record for being the longest surviving COVID-19 patient in Sungai Buloh Hospital. I was in coma for 16 days, on ventilator for 17 days, and I stay in ICU for all my 53 days in hospital. And how did I get it so bad? I was probably infected in early March. On 17 March, my clinic doctor still treated me for flu and cough. By the time I got to Sunway Medical Center on 18 March, I already had a serious breathing problems. From there, I was transferred to Sungai Buloh Hospital. My condition was so bad that I had to pass out in the ambulance. I cannot remember anything for the time until I woke up 16 days later on the 2nd April.
While Tam Boon was in the ambulance, I managed to speak to him. When he arrived in Sungai Buloh, he was in a critical state of septic shock. He had to be put on the ventilator immediately. The next 24 to 72 hours were very critical. I was advised to be prepared for the worst. Septic shock is a potentially fatal condition, and more than 50% of septic shock cases usually result in death. I was devastated by the news. Tam Boon's condition remained critical even after 72 hours. The next 2 weeks were the most difficult time of my life. I did not know what update I would get from the doctor each day. I broke down and cried many times. Katrina and Joyce, our two daughters, were my pillars of practical help and strength. Pastor Chris Kam texted to say the church was praying for Tam Boon. I also had strong support from our Bangsa Cell, friends, and relatives. I held on to God's promise in Isaiah 41 verse 10. Fear not, for I am with you. Be not dismayed, for I am your God. I will strengthen you. I will help you. I will uphold you with my righteous right hand. It was scary when Tam Boon's condition worsened on 31st March. There was not enough oxygen to his lungs and a tracheostomy was considered. This is a risky procedure to insert a tube through his neck. 1st April was the worst day. All his key organs had problems. Tam Boon not only had the risk of heart failure, his lungs were hazier and his kidneys were not functioning. He also needed blood transfusion. That day, we nearly lost Tam Boon. Looking back, the Holy Spirit took control of the situation. He guided the cell to travail for Tam Boon while he prompted the cell member to suggest renunciation and repentance identification prayers. Led by Pastor Jin Leong, a Zoom prayer meeting was quickly organized by our cell leaders. I stood in a gap for Tam Boon to renounce all the temple worship and idols in his life and also repented from all occult practices. After the prayer, Zechariah 3 verse 4 was released, which I took to mean that the Lord had accepted my prayer and that the enemy no longer had a legal hold on Tam Boon. In Zechariah 3 verse 4, the angel said to those who were standing before him, "Take off his filthy clothes." Then he said to Joshua, "See, I have taken away your sin, and I will put rich garments on you." God is holy. When sins and bondages were removed, the power of God came through swiftly. The very next day, 2nd April, was a joyous day for all. Tam Boon woke up that morning and he could respond to commands. His lungs improved so much that the doctors considered the removal of the ventilator. I will never forget this day, which was also Joy's 18th birthday. God granted her wish to be her father awake. The ventilator was removed a day later. What a miraculous turnaround.
Even in coma, God did not leave me nor forsake me. God was with me. He gave me a dream. In the dream, I was seated in the total darkness inside a very crowded train. The train had to pass through a blazing furnace. As the train went through the fire, I felt the heat. My whole body was very hot, just like Daniel and his friends in the Bible. I was not consumed by the fire. Nothing happened to me. but all the people in the train perished. The Lord lifted me up with a dream and reminded me that because I love Him, He will rescue me, as in the Psalm 91. He gave me hope and I would live and not die. I remember waking up in the morning on the 2nd April. The ventilator tube was still inside my throat. It was very painful. I cried, "Lord, please help me. Please heal me." I told the Lord that I did not have my Bible. The Holy Spirit reminded me again of Psalm 91, that the Lord was with me and would not harm put before me. The Holy Spirit also reminded me that my cell members would surely be praying earnestly for me, just like how they had prayed for someone else in the past. That also lifted up my spirit. A day later, when the ventilator tube was removed, a few doctors were at my bedside. I heard Dr. Ang say, "You are a miracle." I replied, "My mighty God has saved me." I could not speak well, and I also could not swallow for about 2 weeks as my throat muscles were injured by the tube. Ventilators saved lives, but ventilator also caused pain and harm. For weeks, I was without my phone and was cut off from my family and friends. I lay down on my bed each day, alert but weak and pain, with bed sores and having to go to dialysis. I often cried to the Lord. I pray whatever Bible verses I remember, and I pray to the Lord in my mind with songs like "How Great Thou Art" and "Amazing Grace." When I spoke to my wife for the first time on the 17th April, I was happy and comforted to know that many people was praying for me. On 1st May, when I was given my phone and my iPad, I can see messages of love and prayer support from members and pastor in DMC. I also discovered that myself had gathered daily to pray and pledged for God's mercy for my life. I cried, feeling very blessed to be in the body of Christ. God heard the pledge of His people and He answered their prayers. I am very thankful to many people who journeyed with me, and especially myself, who prayed earnestly for me. I am especially grateful to my dearest wife. She stood in the gap for me to pray for my condition, where most critical on the 1st April. Because of that, she did. God snatched me from the jaws of death.
It was by God's grace and mercy that Tambun survived COVID-19. We are very grateful to the doctors and nurses who took great care of him. We are also very thankful to Abangsa Cell, which gathered daily to worship and pray until Tambun was discharged and safely at home, believing always that God will save and restore Tambun miraculously. Their commitment was total, and the daily sessions of more than 50 days have brought a whole meaning to praise and prayer, and also to Cell life. We are also very grateful to many people and pastors from other churches who prayed daily for Tambun. My journey with God will never be the same again as I reflect on His goodness, faithfulness, and promises. Nothing is impossible with God. I encourage everyone to pray without ceasing and be encouraged that God hears our prayers. Our God will never leave us nor forsake us. I also urge everyone to join a cell.
Yes, it was a miracle that I survived COVID-19. I'm thankful and I am safely back with my family at home. On the hospital bed, I have learned that money is not everything and it should be the main priority in life. Look, going forward, I plan to spend more time learning God's word, as His words had the power to bless and heal, as well as to give hope and new life to all hopeless. God has given me a second lease of life for the purpose. I want to make my life count on Jesus. I want to serve Him. All glory to our God Almighty.